Marshal Zhukov wrote, "First period of the Great Patriotic War ended in the complete failure of all the strategic plans of Hitler's high command and in great losses of Nazi Germany's troops and weapons. To a great degree, that predetermined further developments in the course of the Second World War. 1943 began with an all-out Soviet offensive all along the front, from Leningrad to the Caucasus. Germans had been driven back, the population could return. The partisans came out of the forest and the mountains, their task completed. Entire families had served with the partisans, like the Trukhanovs. Now they reclaim their birthright. Ruined homes and gutted factories. Where the Nazis remained, there was universal horror. Had good reason to make haste. In the first 6 weeks of 1943, almost all of the Northern Caucasus was liberated. Mount Elbrus, on February 17th, the red flag marked the victory. What remained was the liberation of the rest of the Caucasus from the 400,000 Germans who were still there.
The unknown war will continue in a moment. Battle of Caucasus.
The Nazis called their fortifications in the Kuban the Blue Line. Novorossiysk and Krymskaya were its strong points. They were almost impregnable. Hitler had ordered that the Kuban bridgehead be held at all costs. On February 1st, the Soviet 47th Army launched its offensive against Novorossiysk. In addition, two seaborne landings gained a foothold behind the German lines at a place later named Malaya Zemlya, the Little Land. Most of these men were wiped out, but Major Cesar Kunyakov led 900 of them to the Misaka Mountain, where they fought off massive German attacks. All through February and into April, the fighting raged. April 17th, the Nazis launched Operation Neptune to throw the defenders of the Little Land into the sea. It was a tiny peninsula on the right bank of the Tsimeska Bay, behind Novorossiysk. Nazi formations of 60 aircraft at a time screamed over the Little Land. Over 1,500 sorties a day, over 2,500 bombs. Four German divisions were committed. The bloodshed in that bridgehead lasted 225 days. One of its defenders recalled 30 years later. He was Colonel Leonid Brezhnev, chief of the political department of the 18th Army. We had the Black Sea behind us and the enemy in front, Brezhnev recalled. It was with particular viciousness that the Nazis attempted to throw us into the sea off Malaya Zemlya. Defenders of the Little Land were not to be moved. Hitler's Operation Neptune failed. On April 20th, the Berlin Philharmonic celebrated Hitler's birthday. In the Taman Peninsula, the Soviets were beginning their major efforts to wipe out the Nazis.